Welcome home, my lady. What? What are you gawping at? I'll have you know I'm quite fond of the Rising Stones.
Lord Forchenot is not to hear of this visit. And I should also like the children to have their gifts, ere my husband makes his return.
As you wish, my lady.
Master Alfano, Mistress Alice, if you'd accompany me upstairs.
We shan't be long.
The twins have been sending letters home from time to time, recounting their latest adventures. I am sure they withhold certain details, of course, if only to keep me from worrying. Yet a mother worries all the same. In the early days especially, I tried to support them as best I could, sending the Scion's coin and other such donations. Fortunately, they have found the strength to overcome adversity time and time again. Their words grow more confident with every letter, their depictions more vivid. The triumphs and defeats, the joys and sorrows. It is clear that they have come to find value in every experience. But of those they treasure most, it would seem that meeting you might be the most impactful. Why, since that fateful day, I do believe there has not been a single missive in which you were not mentioned by name. It is plain they care for you, and I am glad they have such a steadfast companion watching over them. Under normal circumstances, I would offer you tea, but alas, these are anything but. In any event, why don't you keep me company whilst we await my children's return? Perhaps you might regale me with a tale or two of your exploits.
When you mentioned gifts, I wasn't sure what to expect. Mother, I...
Oh, look how well it fits you. And the style is to your liking?
It's perfect. Exactly what I would have chosen. But please, tell me you had something different made for Alphino.
Naturally, you are hardly little children anymore. And while I shall miss dressing you in those precious matching outfits, I must respect the individuals you have grown to become. See for yourself.
Thank you for the splendid clothes, Mother. Stylish, comfortable, and eminently practical.
I am so glad you like them. They are, however, missing one final touch.
If you would allow me, Master Alphino.
Wait, are these...
A sage's tools of the trade. They belonged to your father. Though he may as well be chained to his desk these days, as a student he was often called upon to venture into the field. He wielded those armaments, both to heal and to harm in no few battles. None so fierce as those you two have braved, perhaps, but battles nonetheless. Thus did I pull them out of storage, to show you that he was not always the man who stands in vehement opposition to you now. And also because it would be a terrible waste of ridiculously expensive House Leveilleur commissioned artistry. Thank you. I am told these devices are quite difficult to master. But someone of your extensive experience should soon have them darting about with grace and aplomb. May the wisdom in that crystal serve you well. And please, try to find common ground with your father, that you might come and go without need for this awful subterfuge.
We will, Mother. I promise.
My final gifts to you, before you run off, are an observation and a suggestion. Firstly, Forshinoh has ever been a serious man, but it was only after you were born that he truly lost himself in his work. I may not know the Forum's inner workings, but I know your father's. The timing of that change in him holds some significance. Secondly, do not seek to best your father with words. Far better that you simply show him. Let him discover the merit of your actions, after they cannot be undone.
Oh, Mother.
We shall take your wisdom to heart. Thank you again for these gifts, and farewell for now.
Safe travels, my children. Eat well, stay warm, and keep your friends close.
Yes.
Thank you.
Set. Just the four of you, was it?
Three. I'm already attuned to the crystal in Thavnir.
You are? Oh. I would have preferred more test subjects. Oh, well, never mind. If our three travelers could line up here, please. Take a deep breath, and I'll soon have you soaring through the ether. Oh, and one last thing. You might experience a teensy-weensy touch of violent ethereal sickness. Good luck!
What?
Thavnir, home to city-state Rads-At-Har. Rising from the southeast waters of the Bounty, this Isle of Plenty served as the battleground for a conflict between two peoples. Their cultures bled into one another until a unique amalgamation was distilled from the chaos, in a process not unlike their precious alchemy. Once solidified as a single nation, an adamant stance of neutrality would hold invaders at bay. For a time. Now across this vibrant isle creeps a fog of malice. What choice do you have? What chance? Against such an insidious foe. Thank you.
I've seen fairer faces after a bout of bad shellfish. Let me bring you something to drink. That should help settle your bellies.
There was a note with Kryl's instructions. Don't let Astinian roam the markets alone. He's alarmingly bad with coin.
Thank you.
What happened here?
Their dress marks them as alchemists. I see no evidence of injury or poison.
Thinkest thou they but slumber?
I believe so. Whether it is by choice is another question entirely.
Oh, we have guests.
You must excuse the poor welcome. Long days and longer nights have taken their toll, as you can see. I am Vashan, servant to the satrap. My task was, in fact, to wake these good men and women, if you will allow. People of the great work, I come bearing new scales.
Scales? We have new scales?
Yes, my friends. Gather round. I have them right here.
Now I can continue my experiment.
Many thanks.
One for me.
Those are dragon scales.
Yes, such materials are vital to their most pressing research.
And we are fortunate to have them. Our experiments are so close to bearing fruit. Soon we will have a talisman capable of nullifying the etheric emissions from that accursed tower. Did I say something wrong? Are you not here with Vashan? Wait, who are you people? Of course! You're the one Kryl sent. The warrior of light we've been waiting for.
This is a day of celebration. Praise be to Sindaruva!
The winds have shifted. I feel it. The end to our toil is near.
I feel it too. My head hasn't been this clear in days.
Tell me, how did you acquire those scales?
Curious that it concerns you so. But worry not. They were freely given by the dragon with whom our satrap has forged a lawful pact.
That is well.
You must be quite familiar with Dragonkin, yes?
Is this their congealed blood I see on your weapon?
Speaking of dragon blood, you yourself have been infused with it, have you not? I should like to draw a file or two, if so. Now, see here.
Come along. I must insist that you visit our laboratory.
Cease your shoving, or so help me.
Oh dear, your poor companion. What with the new scales and your timely arrival, my colleagues are a little giddy with excitement. No harm will come to him, I promise. Meanwhile, shall we find a quiet place to talk? As you may have guessed, I am Nidana, the alchemist who sent the request to your mistress Kryl. We have workshops across the nation collaborating on this research project. But it is here, at the Great Work, where I collate our results. Come with me, all of you, and I can explain the crux of the situation.
Mm-hmm.